Previously, I've posted a video on drawing aldehyde and ketone for C3H6O. Recently, there was a request to post a video drawing the remaining isomers for C3H6O, and that brings us to this video. So here are the two structures, one for aldehyde and one for ketone. And we're going to continue on to figure out the rest of the isomers. Before we begin to find all the other isomers, it'll be helpful for us to know a little bit about this formula, as in how many rings or pi bonds it can have. That brings us to calculating IHD for this formula. IHD stands for Index of Hydrogen Deficiency. Sometimes it's also used interchangeably for degree of unsaturation, unsaturation index, or double bond equivalence. Basically, what it does is it will tell us how many rings or double or triple bonds that are present in this formula. This number is very useful since it will give us a target to work towards. So let's start by calculating the IHD. The way we do it is by comparing our C3H6O formula with an alkane containing the same number of carbons. In this case, our benchmark is propane, C3H8. I'll post a detailed video explaining more on IHD if you're interested. Just let me know in the comments below. Propane, C3H8, has 8 hydrogens, whereas our formula, C3H6O, has 6 hydrogens. When calculating IHD, we ignore the oxygen. So next, what we do is we subtract the hydrogens, and that gives us 2 hydrogen. IHD will be half of that number, meaning half of 2, and that gives us 1. So we have IHD of 1. And what does that mean? It means C3H6O has 1 ring or 1 double bond. Rings can be in this form, where it's a cyclic compound containing all carbon, or since we have an oxygen in this compound, it could be a ring containing oxygen inside the ring. Or the double bond, it can be between 2 carbons, C-C double bond. Or we can have a double bond between carbon and oxygen, since we have oxygen in this formula. Since we're dealing with only one oxygen atom in this formula, I think it'll be helpful if we recall all the functional groups that has one oxygen before we continue. So here are the 4 functional groups we'll be working with in the next few minutes. Another thing to keep in mind is the number of bonds that each atom normally makes. Hydrogen makes 1 bond, oxygen makes 2 bonds, and carbon makes 4 bonds. We're now ready to draw out all our isomers for C3H6O. Let's get started. I've placed our reference on the top right. So we're going to start off by working with ring containing all carbons. Since we have 3 carbons in this formula, we'll just place them connected to each other like this. Then we'll add in the bonds on each carbon. Remember, carbon makes 4 bonds, so we're going to fill out each carbon with 2 bonds. And now that we have that, we've placed 1 oxygen in one of the carbon. It doesn't matter which carbon because it's all equivalent at this point. And then that oxygen, we've attached a hydrogen to go with it. Because remember, oxygen makes 2 bonds. So now we've used out all the carbon and 1 oxygen and 1 hydrogen. So let's fill out the rest of the structure with hydrogens. This is what we get, and it's called cyclopropanol. Now let's add in 1 oxygen in the ring. Smallest ring consists of 3 atoms. We have 2 carbon and 1 oxygen. So let's stick the extra carbon here, and we fill out the structure with hydrogens, and this is what we get. We can also expand the ring to contain 4 atoms. So we'll have 3 carbon and 1 oxygen in the ring like this. And then we fill out the rest of the structure with hydrogens, and this is what we get. So these are the 2 structures that we can get in a ring containing oxygen. Here are our skeleton for C-C double bond. It's an alkene with 3 carbon long. We can place the OH in multiple places like this. And it looks like it will give us a total of 3 isomers. And we fill out the rest of the structures with the remaining 5 hydrogens, and this is what we get. Looks like we're done working on propene. Now, if I swap the position of carbon and oxygen, we can get yet another isomer, like this. Next, we move on to C double bond O. Let's start with 3 carbons straight in a row, and we're gonna place our C double bond O on the first carbon. And then we fill up with the rest of the hydrogen, and this is what we get. This will give us the aldehyde. Remember, we've seen this at the beginning of the video. Now, if we move the C double bond O to the second carbon, like this, and then we fill it up with hydrogens, that's going to give us a ketone, which is also what we've seen at the beginning of the video. So this is the aldehyde and the ketone. And with that, we're done drawing all the isomers for C3H6O. Here are the 9 isomers that we've drawn out. If you find other isomers which are not mentioned in this video, definitely do mention them in the comments. I really appreciate it. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. Do subscribe, like, and share this video if you find it helpful. It'll help the channel grow, and I'll really appreciate it.